Hello everyone, welcome to the next episode of Toy Story 2. In this episode, we're going to take on the evil Emperor Zurg and show him who's boss. Well, that's so generic. That is literally the tagline for most kind of videos or...
So, we meet again, Buzz Lightyear, for the last time.
It's Zurg! Watch out, he's got an ion blaster!
I love the way that it's a start. There's kind of a very good nod towards Star Wars. As a kid, I hadn't seen Star Wars by that point, and I was like, I don't know what the "I am your father" joke is. Obviously now I know it, and I'm sick of it. I prefer Star Trek better, and I think Star Wars is absolute... I think Star Wars is pretty bollocks, even the old ones. Like, I can't claim Star Trek is absolutely fantastic. It's visually not always the most appealing show ever, but in terms of its morality and a lot of what it tries to do, I think it's much better than Star Wars. Star Wars, the films anyway, don't seem to have any idea of morality, which they kind of purport to have. It's like the Jedi's belief that all... I've said this before in loads of videos. By the way, you can't hit him with lasers. You have to spin things back. You can spin those balls back. The green ones home, and well, home quite viciously. The blue, red ones won't. So you have to jump. Basically, you have to press spin and then jump, not jump and then spin, because otherwise you'll do the stomp. So it's like the Jedi's think that they are some like hot shit. They basically think they're the shit of the galaxy and they're there to police it. But the Sith deal in absolutism, and that what they're doing, thinking that they are there to protect everyone, is a form of absolutism. So it's technically, it feels like the Jedi are in a way just as bad as the Sith. They do try to help people, but their belief set is no different to the Sith, and I find that kind of, it's difficult to really get behind. If you fall off, you don't lose a life, you just lose some health. And again, the kind of the green thing, very, very inspired. Very inspired by how the Emperor gets killed in Final Fantasy 18.5. No, in obviously Star Wars Episode 6. I'll save here because I don't want to mess up again. But yeah, Emperor Zurg is a different fight because it changes the way you need to fight him. Pardon me. A lot of the guys in here can just be defeated by standing there and firing a gun at them for eternity, whereas he does require something a little different, which is what I like. You've got to change your strategy up. Again, he's like every other boss, but he's a little more difficult to defeat because he takes time, and he kind of likes to hover off the edges quite a lot.
Sleek, take the pedals. Rex, you navigate. Ham and potatoes.
Oh my goodness.
The levers and knobs.
Whoa. This does look like a dystopian future because of how crap the cars look.
From the outside.
Oh no. Ah, oh, dear. I just love Buzz's reaction to that. And the next level is Airport Infiltration. Now this is another... Basically this entire segment of videos you're seeing here are taken from the time that I severely messed up. Oh man, look at that airport security. Actually, that's what I've noticed in LA. When I went down... to LA for E3, not horribly name-dropping like Surface in there. I noticed that like you did walk in and you're straight at those desks, whereas in a lot of them in the UK, there's a little bit towards being straight in there to take your luggage away. At least a bit more. Like I tend to fly from either Liverpool or Manchester Airport. This time when I went down to London, well, they booked from London, so I had to go from London. Which wasn't fun. I'm not a huge fan of travelling down to London. I'm not a huge fan of London, to be honest. So yeah, this is... The weird thing about this is that there's a window there, and I know. But this level does a good job of kind of making you feel like the film did when you saw all those conveyor belts, but in a different sense, a gameplay sense, one that you can almost find a bit bamboozling, and to a certain degree that this level does fulfil the bamboozlement. God, these guys take forever to kill when you spin them. Word of advice, don't spin them. Just shoot them. But yeah, make sure you get every coin you see, because again, this is one of the levels where you can end up at the kind of the end, and you don't want to backtrack for them, but you might have to because you've missed quite a few. But yeah, all the enemies. But I like this kind of level. Actually, it's interesting. I wonder what Buzz would feel if he went through an X-ray scanner. Obviously, I know an X-ray is not the same as MRI. It's not it doesn't involve magnets. But I wonder if there's a noted difference going through an X-ray scanner, because I know X-ray scanners they don't do it, but they do have the potential to damage like some sort of electronic like storage like SD cards. They never do. They always tend to say keep them in shielded medium, but I don't know many people who do that. And I don't know if it does make a big difference. I'm not sure if it makes a difference to hard drives as well, being hard drives are basically like large storage floppy disks. Well, that's a bit of bollocks, if I'm going to be honest. They're quite a lot different because, you know, the storage size makes you obviously believe they're quite a bit different. But they are quite similar in the sense that they are like magnetic disks. Just you can only store 1.44 megabytes on a floppy disk. Oh man, that's like not even one MP. That's not one MP3. That was back in the day. Like you can't even store like a decently sized JPEG at that anymore. In fact, we used to store, I think, a lot of MIDIs. You'd just shove a load of MIDIs on them. In fact, I still have a bunch of old floppy disks at home. I might do a video when I get back home talking about that. I also said in another video about home being different, obviously, at Bangor and there. So I was meaning home, just for some clarifications. Ham is around there, by the way, so just something to note. And there is one coin, so you can come back with 49 coins. Okay, so the first area we want to... There's nothing really of any, like, significance up here that we need to worry about, so we want to head up here first. By nothing of any significance, I mean nothing we need to come back to with a load of items, which is nice. I like the music in this level as well. It's kind of understated. Oh, there we go. On the way down, you can collect any coins you missed. And the collectible of this area is the tyke. I'm sure many of you remember the little nod to that they had in Toy Story. In Toy Story 3, there were a load of the little collectibles lying around which you could get. Again, I love the fact that Toy Story 3 made reference to Toy Story 2, the games anyway, and it just felt like the team who worked on it did a fantastic job. I said there were issues with Toy Story 3, as there are issues with Toy Story 2, but I think Toy Story 2, doesn't try and come off as being anything but a game like this, whereas Toy Story 3 has the feeling that it's trying to come off as maybe a little bit more, or maybe that's just me wanting more out of it because of this game. I'm not sure. I would like love to ask someone who has played that game and hasn't had the experience with Toy Story 2 that I've had, being that I think this is the best platforming game. It came out, and I honestly enjoyed playing this more than I enjoyed playing Toy Story. Sorry, more than I enjoyed playing Banjo-Kazooie. Oh wow, that was close. It wasn't close to hit me. And more than I enjoyed playing Banjo-Kazooie or Super Mario 64 platformers, which came out around about the same time. And a lot of people would say that it copied the kind of style of that, and I just kind of don't agree with that at all, because it is its own game in a right, in the same that it's level based. It doesn't. The levels are extremely segregated in the sense that, you know, you're in a menu, you choose the level, and you go in them. Whereas, you know, Super Mario 64 was different because there was an overworld, and the same with Banjo Kazooie. And I don't think this game would have worked with an overworld. I think that was a good choice to have it just as purely defined levels, because it's more of a journey with this than necessarily Super Mario 64 is, because it's following the journey to chase after Woody, whereas it is chasing after Bowser, but you're essentially in a castle. Like, it's partially explained within the medium, within kind of the story. Oh, there's the coin that we missed. So I honestly think this is one of the best platformers out there, and I know a lot of you will look at me and go, but it's the fact that it works so well, and I don't know. I wish there was another game like it, a sequel, which was just different levels. Like, to be honest, I think what I'm trying to say is I wish Toy Story 3 was like this, which is silly because Toy Story 3 was a... Sorry, I'm going to move the microphone. Toy Story 3 was a great game for what it was, and what it was, you know, visually, it was stunning. And I would almost want a remake of this game in Toy Story 3, but again, Toy Story 3 didn't come out on the PC, and it probably uses custom everything, so it's a shame. And there's no real way to up-res this. Okay, so this guy is quite mean. A lot of his weights are outside of each of the rooms. It's in the three main rooms. There's one in this room, which is not going to be fun. I'm not going to enjoy. You've got plenty of time for this, by the way, as long as you know where they are. Which you can say about all of them, so it's stupid me saying it. 10 minutes in, and I feel like we're doing really good progress this time. Much better than last time. So there's one there, and there's also going to be one inside this room, a little to the there. The last one Now, this took me a little while to find out because I wasn't too sure where it was. But the last one's on top of the conveyor belt, so it does require you to jump up, which I think is a little bit cheeky in the time limit, but why not? It can also be annoying if something goes through that, one of those goes through it, the thingamajigs, you know what I'm talking about. But again, well, Buzz just shrugs that off, wish I was in cutscene the entire- no I don't, because that would just be buggy. Okay, keep on playing. So what we want to do is, Mr. Potato Head's in the room that's- oh gosh, that was awful jump, time jump. So Mr. Potato Head is in this room here, so we're not going to go here straight away, I'm just going to collect the coins from him. We want to get to Mr. Potato Head, we essentially have to climb this rig twice that's in here, and I think that's really, really not fun. This is, I think, where a lot- I don't know, in the last episode, asked what you felt of kind of this game. What you felt of, like, was the hardest level. I think, in a way, this bit here can be construed as one of the hardest bits. God damn it. What I also don't like is that- oh, I've got way more than enough coins. I don't know why I'm collecting them all. As you can see there, the tyke is over in the corner. Remember that later on, because otherwise you'll forget about it and it'll be the most embarrassing thing ever. But yeah, this is obviously, I don't know why, because the wing's halfway across, which means one half of the wing is double as long, but half as dense. Basically weighs half the amount, which, I don't know, is that what plane wings are like? Any aviation specialists that think this is a bit of bollocks? I don't know why they'd leave the wings like this as well, because I assume you just don't want to damage wings. Although it's amazing the kind of stresses they put up with. You know, you look out the window in Turbulence, which I hate flying, by the way, I absolutely hate it. You can see it wibbling up and down, like, and it scares the willies off me, if I'm going to be honest. But obviously, they're made to put up with that stress. Oh god, the chug there, it's textual Odin, as you can see. Now, actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go further up this, even though we've got Ham's thing, because there is a tyke here. There are two tykes in this room, something to remember. Actually, Ham's, I think Ham's in the other area? No, Ham's back where we started. So again, it's pretty much got it now. The reason being is you don't want to have to run all the way back up and then just jump here. Because you can't easily jump back. I mean, you probably could with that wind blowing in the right way. I mean, we could give it a go. Because there is a second tyke we can get as well. Oh, we made it. Now that is that's crazy. Now there's a tyke below here. I'm not sure if we can make it. Oh, we can! Fantastic! That's worked out so much nicer than it did last time, which means I don't need to worry going in there again. Three shining symbols at the top. And we'll probably, no, we won't get like them, but all shiny, which is a shame. God, this playthrough is going so much better than last time. So happy. It depresses me when I don't do very good in these games, because I know everything is there, it's just sometimes it's not coming out. Anyway, as I said, I really don't like flying. I find it a horribly stressful experience. I'll still need to do a video that, you know, just talks about my experiences with my anxiety, but one of the kind of places where my anxiety still kind of exists is flying. I find it horrible. I didn't find it as bad for when I flew to LA. Or flew to America, I should say, even though, you know, I was halfway there and I was like, why the hell is there, you know, you've flown all this way and now you can see America, and then suddenly it's like, oh, I still got to fly over America. I forgot how big America is. But yeah, I hate it. It sets my anxiety on full pelt and it's just horrible. I hate so much flying. I just feel, oh, okay, we can walk out of the boss fight. We can be like, no, it's not a good time for me right now, Prospector. So basically what you want to do is you want to jump over him, spin, and you want to wait for him to do that, then spin, then wait for him to do that, and spin, and then wait for him to do that, and spin. Kind of very... there we go. And with a tiny amount of health left, I'm liking that. But for me, it's totally irrational, and I fully admit that it's an irrational fear, because... God, this reminds me of a video. We can teabag Pete. Oh, come on, camera. There we go. Teabagging Pete. We can't crouch, but it's the way that after a while he puts his hands on his hips. And he's like, yeah, you're my bitch. Wait for it. Wait for it. It's worth this. It's worth it. I promise. Oh, come on, Buzz. There we go. He just kind of looks around like smugly, probably like, yeah, what are you going to do about this? I'm getting a old prospector to suck my balls. Maybe not the best thing you can do, but or to suck my metal underside, plastic underside. But yeah, back to flying. It's one of those things that I really do hate with so much passion. It's irrational, and I could if I wanted to, and I really do need to look up the physics of, like, the tolerances of a plane and what all the stages are normal. Just someone to talk me through, like, different things about turbulence so I can logically reason through. But even with that, I think I would just be horribly fearful, because when I feel dropping, like, any kind of drop in the stomach, it just goes. Like, all reason goes out the window, and I think I do realize that, and I'm fully aware that that's the case. Okay, so there's still a question. This is like the only time I think that I've got nearly everything else before the question mark one, which is pretty amazing, because question marks are usually quite close to the beginning of the level. Also, this level is going to be quite a long time, 16 minutes so far. But yeah, I used to be anxious about a lot of things, and now that has long since passed. I'm very good at dealing with most of my anxiety, but the issue still is flying on planes. I think the worst one, on basically this holiday, I went to see Captain Noodles in Ireland, which was fantastic. £40 ticket with Ryanair. Most of you know Ryanair and know of it, and how cheap it is if you don't bring anything. Literally, they were even planning to charge you to use the bathroom on the plane. Granted, most flights with Ryanair are short haul, but for the long haul ones, people are like, well, I'll just piss on the floor. And I totally go by that. If they're charging you for the toilets, it's ridiculous. But yeah, also this one here, you can jump over it. So I would recommend not jumping it, just jump straight up and do that. But yeah, it's one of those things. I wish I could be logical about it, because I do feel that I'm logical about a lot of things. Again, that's me kind of wishing that I am, because there are lots of different times when I was not as logical as I wanted to be. And I could easily say, give you a handful of them, like flying on the planes, but also how I dealt with certain relationships as well, like, oh god, come on, get me up here. There we go. Keep on playing. And that's pretty much everything we've got to do now. I've got to go back to the tykes in the corner of the room, and let's have some fun. But yeah, mainly flying. This is why I'm talking about it, because they've taken apart everything now. These are the flaps, but is this part of a really small plane, or what is this? Well, who cares? We don't really need to know. Thanks for getting all the passengers! But yeah, this level can be done really easily and really pain-free, as long as you don't fall off that structure about 8 billion times. So what is this? I just want to have a look. It's like the nose? Or is it the back? It's the tail of a plane. There's the tail of a plane. Yeah, I should have noticed by that. BDC. Big... Oh wow, that's shooting from far distance. There's nothing. British delicatessens convoluted. Nope. What is your best anagram of BDC for an aircraft? It's not going to be Big Dick Cock, because that's about as witty. It's not witty. Comparisons. You can't really compare. But that's probably the unwittiest thing I can think of right now for that. Oh, very nicely timed, sir. Very nicely failed there also, sir. There we go, get up here. But yeah, it worked out a hell of a lot nicer if you just do it that kind of way. At least things seem to flow better. You don't even need to use the pole to get over. And 54 with the last piece of planet token. So anyway, guys, I will see you in the next episode of Toy Story... Did I say 3 then? That's unusual. In the next episode of Toy Story 2. Take care. Bye-bye. And beyond! Look at Prospector's face. He looks so stupid. Oh dear. Prospector, what is this? Why do we even exist?